Assalamu alaikum, everybody, and peace be with you all. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wal asr, innal insana lafi husr. Illa allazina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. Dear brothers and sisters, before I go any further with my remarks and also introducing our interfaith partners who have been here for last 35 years working with us in solidarity of building bridges and fighting for peace and justice in our beautiful city, I will also like to take a pleasure to introduce the son and the daughter of Imam Mohamed Hassan, the late. They are also here with us. So inshallah, once we are done with our notes and our comments, inshallah, please take time to do the condolences with them as well, inshallah. And there'll be a lot more that the Somali leadership, inshallah, from the Central Ohio will be doing forward, collaborating and letting everybody know what the status is of this case that, you know, we unfortunately has been witnessing for last quite some time. Dear brothers and sisters, the beautiful city of Columbus has lost a loving father, a husband, a family man, and a leader who was not loved by few, but thousands of people all around the nation and also abroad. This beautiful soul was lost to an act of senseless violence and hatred. This is not the first time a faith leader, a social advocate, and a peace builder has been targeted in our beautiful city. You all remember a couple of years ago, a youth advocate, Amber Evans, also unfortunately had the same destination of being brutally murdered by her kidnappers. And that this tragedy unfortunately takes home the memories of Amber Evans as well. But let's hope that and pray that it is definitely the last time our city is witnessing such tragedy. Our city has seen enough of such violence, and it's time we put an end to such atrocities and life loss tragedies. We request our city's leadership, our law enforcement, and our public safety to bring justice and don't let any stone be unturned in their efforts to resolve the case of Imam Mohamed. The family of the Dr. Mohamed and all those who we have lost to the senseless hate and homicides over the years, you all have our support. The Muslim community stands united with all our American brothers and sisters, locally and nationally, for support and solidarity for social justice for everyone. We are each other's keepers, my brothers and sisters, and together we move forward and stronger as a city and as a multicultural community and a nation. There is no room for hate in our Central Ohio ecology, and that's the message we have to send out loud and clear. And your presence today here is definitely a symbol and a representation of that conviction, conviction and messaging out to everyone that there is no hate in Central Ohio. My brothers and sisters, we call everyone who stands here under the sovereignty of the American flag that less justice shall prevail, justice shall propel, justice shall thrive, and justice shall see no color, race, or creed in our societies to give hope, a full-fledged chance for a brighter and prosperous tomorrow for everyone. My brothers and sisters, let's unite our efforts and put our conviction to work. We all need to do our parts, and I would like to re-echo the famous saying of Martin Luther Jr. King, the best leader our nation and our land has seen in decades and centuries. He said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects everyone." My brothers and sisters, we all came here in peace, we marched in peace, and we all will leave in peace as well. Now let's hear from all the great faith leaders of our community.